वासुदेवाय नारायणं नमस्कृत्य नरं चैव नरोत्तमं देवीं सरस्वतीं व्यासं ततो जयमुदीरये। जय श्री कृष्ण चैतन्य प्रभु नित्यानंद श्री अद्वैत गदाधर श्रीवासदि गौर भक्त वृंदा। हरे कृष्णा कृष्ण कृष्ण हरे हरे, हरे राम 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 हरे हरे। हरे कृष्णा। So today we are going to discuss about the conversation between Sri Chaitanya Mahaprabhu and Haridas Thakur. This is a very, very beautiful portion from Chaitanya Charitamrita Antya Leela. There are two chapters in Antya Leela. Two chapters exclusively speaking about Haridas Thakur. So one chapter is the glories of Haridas Thakur, and the second chapter is the passing away of Haridas Thakur. In these two chapters, Haridas Thakur very beautifully and glorifying the holy name, and Lord Chaitanya is so happy, joyful, listening Haridas Thakur glorifying the holy name. Very beautiful chapters. So when Lord Chaitanya met Haridas Thakur in Jagannath Puri, Lord Chaitanya had a lot of respect, and Lord Chaitanya used to glorify Haridas Thakur so much, and he had a routine of collecting Jagannath Prasad from temple, and on the way when he is going for noon bath in the ocean, Mahaprabhu will hand over this prasad to Haridas Thakur. This is a daily program. When Lord Chaitanya stayed in Jagannath Puri, he made this as a habit that going every day to Haridas Thakur and handing over prasada. And in case sometimes when Lord Chaitanya doesn't get time or if he is occupied with something else, he will send very important devotees to meet Haridas Thakur and hand over prasada. So this is a kind of a daily custom Lord Chaitanya practiced. And whenever Lord Chaitanya meets Haridas Thakur, with a great respect, he will glorify Haridas Thakur and try to listen from Haridas Thakur about the glories of holy name. In this way, both these wonderful personalities had a very intimate relationship. So in one such meeting, Chaitanya Mahaprabhu asked Haridas Thakur, because Mahaprabhu knows Haridas Thakur is not from a Brahminical family, and he is from a family of meat eaters. So generally meat eaters are not qualified for spiritual life because they lose the quality called mercy. By killing animals and by eating their flesh and blood, they lose the quality called mercy, and because they lose this quality, they can't practice spiritual life. So because Haridas Thakur is from such a family, so Lord Chaitanya one day asked Haridas Thakur, "Haridas, how will be the Yavanas who are always eating meat and they don't hesitate even to kill a cow and eat her meat. They are doing such a abominable sinful activity. They lead a sinful life. And how do you think they can also take up spirituality? Lord Chaitanya, even though he is the Supreme Personality of Godhead, like a very innocent student, Lord Chaitanya is asking this question to Haridas Thakur. Then Haridas Thakur says, whoever they may be, how much ever sinful they may be, if they loudly chant Krishna's name, Rama's name, this holy name is so powerful that can destroy any amount of sin. And Yavanas, basically they chant loudly Haram, Haram. And when they are upset with certain behavior, they loudly say this word Haram, which means something else. But when they chant Ha Ram loudly, because they are chanting this name, no sin can touch this person. Whatever fallen condition they may be, simply by chanting Rama's name, either directly or indirectly, or you know, even by mistake or without respect, or even to blame someone else, even to insult someone else, if they loudly chant Rama's name, they are qualified for spiritual life. They are not chanting properly, they are chanting Nama Bhas, Nama Aparad. Still, by chanting Krishna's name in offensive way also, that name, holy name, will purify that person. Even if we chant by Nama Aparad, by mistake and by sin, by offense, even then holy name is very powerful. Then Ajamila cited the example of Haridas Thakur cited the example of Ajamila. Ajamila chanted Nama Abhas, Abhas Nam. Still he got purified. So this Yavanas, from which family I came from, even for scolding people, they used to chant Rama's name. Because they loudly chant Rama's name, whatever has happened to Ajamila, in the same way, this holy name will purify them. So Lord Chaitanya became so happy with the answer of Haridas Thakur. Because Haridas Thakur, not only for sake of talking, he was talking. No, he really believed. Many times, we also speak Krishna conscious philosophy. We discuss Krishna conscious philosophy. We write articles. We read books. But all these things are entirely different from what we behave. A man who speaks, who thinks, and his behavior, if it is all on the same platform, then he is a perfect person. Many times we preach something else to people. We write in books. We write articles. But when it comes to our behavior, it's completely different. So, when Lord Chaitanya heard this from Haridas Thakur, Chaitanya Mahaprabhu became very happy. Still, Mahaprabhu wanted to dig more things from Haridas Thakur. So Mahaprabhu asked, Haridas, what about plants? Okay, human beings, okay, even though they are sinful, and if they chant Krishna's name, even by mistake or aparad, they will be delivered, fine. What about plants? Plants don't have developed consciousness. And for plants and trees, there is nothing called papa and punya, good and bad. They simply exist neutrally in this world. So how will the plants get benefited? See, Mahaprabhu is asking this question to Haridas Thakur as though some innocent baby is asking. So how they will get purified? Then Haridas Thakur said, Mahaprabhu, this question also has got the same answer. What are you doing now? You are delivering the whole world. The purpose of you incarnating in this material world itself is for the deliverance of people. And with tears in his eyes, Haridas Thakur glorified Chaitanya Mahaprabhu and said, if we simply raise our hands and walk down in the streets and in jungle and in the riverside, loudly chanting this Maha Mantra, every single plant, grass, trees, whoever get that vibration, will all get purified and they will get a chance to liberate themselves. So Haridas Thakur told this a wonderful thing. Even plants, that's why Mahaprabhu started this Namasankirtan, Sankirtan on the streets. It is not only for human beings, it's for cats, dogs, cows, buffalo, trees, plants, all the living entities on the street. So Haridas Thakur said, Mahaprabhu, that what you are doing? And Mahaprabhu also said, Haridas Thakur, you are also doing the same thing. Every day 1 lakh names you are walking on the street and chanting. So by chanting Krishna's name loudly on the streets, and Haridas Thakur said, what you did in Jharikhanda forest, Mahaprabhu, I heard from your assistant Balabhadra Bhattacharya. I got the chance to meet him, and Balabhadra Bhattacharya narrated the whole thing to me, what has happened in Jharikhanda forest. Balabhadra Bhattacharya was following you in Jharikhanda forest, and in the Jharikhanda forest you simply raised your arms so beautifully with tears in your eyes and chanting Govinda Keshava Madhava Hari Hari. And Balabhadra Bhattacharya could not believe his eyes. He could see tiger hugging a goat and dancing, you know, the animals who were deadly enemies. You know, the domestic animals and the wild animals can never get along. But Balabhadra Bhattacharya saw tiger is dancing with a goat and bear is dancing with a lion and all these wild animals and coming and licking Mahaprabhu, and they had tears and they were all dancing in their hind legs. Every animal and plant in that jungle cherished the pure chanting of holy name.